Hello there, kitties. I'm Carrie, the vacuum tube witch, and we're moving on with the Rattlecaster project. It is now destringed, and it's time to restring it. And then tune it, and do the corrections of the scale length, so that it can be played again. Let's get to the bench. And get some better lighting on that. So, as you can see, the guitar looks like where we left off yesterday, with no strings. No strings attached. And I've got this little set that I already started opening, the regular slinky set. Also got a crank for the machine heads. And of course, starting my work on the guitar. Put those strings through the holes, making sure they exit through the bridge on the opposite side. All the way. Must be seated in the hole. And do it with all those strings, the 36. Until we have a nice set of strings coming out of the bridge. One string at a time. This machine is closer and closer to killing fascists again. You rebellious little string. So, now it's time to attach those strings to the machine heads. And I will do it in such a way that first I'm gonna do two turns, maybe on the bottom E, I will do something like one turn, because this is a thick one. I think I will do two of them. And then I'll do it in such a way that then the place where a string exits the machine head is pinched both from the bottom and the top. And this is where the crank might come in handy. I might be rattling because of the second pickup. Yeah, it's in place, time to cut it. So I will cut it somewhere at 3 millimeters from the machine head. Let's get a better view on this one. If I can. This is how I cut it. Let's get the rest of those strings. Pulling it and making sure that the piece goes all the way into the hole. And again, two turns under and one over. Maybe not one over, but a half over. this one has to be routed on under this clamp. Some ugly crossovers going on here. Still gotta correct that. Now it's pretty nice. And the last one. After I put it on the machine head, this is where the fun begins. Okay, time to take a tuner and try to adjust them. And tuning a guitar, it should be done in the playing position. Tightening it till it goes into the E. Closer and closer. Okay, so now the tuning is pretty much okay. Let's get back to the desk. Change the light a little bit. And what I'm gonna do now is checking the scale length on the guitar. It's done by pressing a string on the 12th fret, and the note it plays it should be the same as a clean string with no fret. Maybe I should do it on a higher chair. Yeah, I will also need that screwdriver to adjust the scale length on the bridge. And because the indication is above the tune on the 12th fret, I will have to move the block on the bridge a little bit back, and then tune the string again. Still a little bit too high. That means that I might have to use a different gauge string or move this block just a little bit back using a different screw. The scale length of A is correct. D needs a little bit of adjustment. Just a teeny tiny bit. That's it. G needs adjustment. Just a little bit more. find the E. So the bottom E still needs adjustments, and I'm out of the adjustment range. Might be the case that I need to replace the screw, remove the spring. And move the undercarriage all the way to the bridge. Basically, I just need a longer active length of the string. Got a different screw. Let's see now. Rattling around the humbucker. Let's lower the humbucker just a little bit. Still could use a slight adjustment. I might have overdone it. Now it's pretty nice. The Rattlecaster. And this machine is now ready to kill fascists. Okay, see you next time. Either with the Sohorn DRX85 reverberation or delay unit fixes, because I've got a cracking potentiometer in that one. Or with the Dirty Dozen amp build.